Hi guys, so in the previous lesson you learned how to assign MFA requirements to users so that when they log into the console they need to supply that extra factor of authentication. But what you might realize is that this is not requiring you to enter an MFA code when you issue, for instance, a command using the AWS CLI. And in some circumstances we really want to make sure that using the AWS CLI we are also authenticated using that extra factor of authentication. So how can we do that? Well, we can use a policy, and that policy will restrict all actions, including via the CLI, to make sure that we've actually got a certain token present that shows that we've authenticated previously with MFA. So we're going to do a hands-on now just to see how this works. Now in my account, I've got a couple of users. Let's go into Paul. And in this case, Paul is in the administrator access group, so he's got admin access. Now, one of the other things I've done with Paul is I've assigned an MFA device. Now, you know how to do that, so if you haven't got one for Paul, just pause the video and then add an MFA device. Now, once you've done that, we can then continue. Now, this is the policy that we're going to be using. Now, what this policy will do is it will actually deny access unless we have multi-factor authentication. So unless we've actually pre-authenticated with MFA, it's not going to allow actions except for these, the not actions. So these will be allowed. Now, there's a couple of commands down here as well which will run, and I've also got a copy of my access key and secret ID for this user. And what I'm going to do, I'm just copying that, and I'm going to create a profile. So I'm going to use AWS configure dash dash profile and just call it Paul. I'm going to put in the access key ID, come back, get his access key, or rather his secret access key, add that in, the region's fine. So now let's try and run AWS S3 LS, and you can just leave it there, but I'm going to add a bucket name, see if I can see the contents of this bucket. So I need to add on profile Paul, because I want to use these credentials and access that bucket as Paul. And that's fine. I can see that I have some objects within that bucket. So now what we're going to do is copy this entire policy. So copy from the open curlies to the closing curlies just down here. I've got that on my clipboard. Let's come back and we'll go to permissions. And obviously a good way of doing this would be to add it to a permissions policy and then assign it to users and roles, or add it to a permissions policy and assign it to a group. In this case, just for ease of use, we're going to use a inline policy. So I'm going to paste this in, click on review. For name, let's just come back and I'll use this so it's nice and descriptive. Paste that in and then create that policy. So that policy's been assigned, and what we can do now is head back over to the command line and try and reissue the exact same command as before and see what happens. So back on the command line, let's rerun this command. And this time we get an access denied. So we know something's changed. We've now been denied access. Now, of course, what I could do is run AWS IAM list-users and put in Paul's profile. Because remember, there was a, and I just missed Paul there, so just add Paul on. Remember, there was a not action, and that not action had a list of API actions which were excluded. So that works. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you how to actually authenticate with MFA via the command line. Back in our document here, you'll see this command. Now ignore the star, star, star. Just start with AWS, copy all of this, and let's come back to the command line here. In fact, what I'm going to do is just bring this up to the top of the screen so it's a bit easier for you. Paste this in. And we need to get the ARN of our MFA device. So back in IAM, let's go to security credentials and we just copy the ARN up until where it says pull. Don't copy the virtual piece. I'm just going to backspace and delete all this text. So now it should say serial dash number space the ARN we just copied. There should be another space and then dash dash token dash code. And we need to delete this out and actually get the code from our MFA device. My code is 477442. And let's hit enter. And of course I've gone and forgotten to put Paul's profile on, so don't forget to do that. Let's put in profile Paul, and now we're running it as Paul. So great, that worked. Now I'm just going to copy all of this response here. And let's put it into our file, and it's going to be easier to understand what's going on. So I'm just going to paste this in. Now, you can see it a bit more easily here. We've got the access key ID, the secret access key. We've got the session token and an expiration as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill out, you see where I have this section of code here with MFA. This is a profile that we're going to add into our credentials file. And I need to update it with these values. So I'm going to copy the code within the brackets, paste this in. Same for the secret access key. So that's going to go here. And then exactly the same here, I'm going to copy all the way to the end, just backspace. We don't want the comma or the closing. Let's copy, paste this in. Okay, so now we have a block of code. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this entire block of code to my clipboard. Back on the command line, I'm going to use the nano utility and put in the path to my credentials file. And we can see we've got two profiles in here, the default one and then Paul's. I'm going to paste this in and now we have a third profile, which is the one for MFA. So let's save this file. Now, of course, we know that we can't run the S3 command as Paul. It's going to give us an access denied message. But now let's see if we can backspace and use the profile called MFA. And in this case, it works. So what's happened here is we've used the get session token command. So just coming back here, remember this, it's important for the exam. You've got the get session token command. We've used that with our ARN of our MFA device and the token to authenticate using MFA. And that's returned the temporary security credentials. That's these here. We've then been able to use those temporary security credentials to access AWS, and it knows that we've actually pre-authenticated with MFA. So hope that was useful to you. I'll see you in the next lesson.